Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to another episode here on African Confessions. The following story that you're going to be listening to, it was sent to me by one of our dear brother, and this is the translation of the message that he sent to me. Strange things indeed, they do happen in this world. The message that he sent to me, it reads like this. Hello, Brother Nash, how are you? Can you please post my own story as hidden identity? My name, you can call me Kuda, not his real name. I am a man who is aged 42 years old, so I am a truck driver by profession, and for most of my life, I have been traveling. First of all, I was working for Cobro here in Zim, but from there on, I started traveling the roads of Zim, South Africa, and Botswana, delivering goods and making at least what I call a good living. But what most of the people do not know is that my life has been defined not by the many, many kilometers that I have driven, but by the countless women that I have been with along the way. Some of these women, I truly feel sorry for them, because when they think that they were once in love with me, it was not true love, but it was spiritual love. They could not resist me. If it was like done physically, that I propose love to a woman, she will just refuse. But there is a spirit that follows me. I call it the spirit of love that can make any woman to fall for me. So I've come here because I want to confess the truth about my life and the pain that I have to go through on a daily basis. To other men out there, when you say that I have slept with over 200 women, most of the guys that I tell my story, they think that I am the hero, and they always say that next year you are totally invited to the men's conference. But what they don't know is that the more that you sleep with different women, the more that you feel terrible about yourself and dirty, like it taints your spirit. I grew up in a small village in the Midlands province of Zimbabwe. My parents, they were hard-working farmers, and we were living quite a simple life, but there was always something that was different about me, and the name that was given to me, I was given my grandfather's name. So my grandfather really loved me, as well as my other uncle. So my grandfather himself, he was a herbalist. So from a very young age, my grandfather, before he had passed away, he gave me a lot of herbs, saying that these herbs that I am giving you, so that when you are with a woman one day, I want you to be able to perform in bed. We were living a very simple life, and I think that my uncle, the time that he took me and started staying with me, that was when my life totally changed. When I was somewhere around 14 years, my uncle, he was a traditional healer, and he was using a lot of witchcraft, because he used to help those that were mentally ill. At his compound, there were always women and men that would have been brought by their relatives because of their mental illnesses. But my uncle, he was a man who had so much powers that he was able to assist those people. But it was not overnight. Some of them, he would cure them over the years, and some of them, he would cure them within a month. He always told me that I was destined for greatness, and I was someone that was spiritually gifted, and he needed to unlock the gift that was inside of me, the gift that had been granted to me by my ancestors. One day, my uncle took me deep into the bushes. This was what we used to do. We would go into the bushes, then we would look for some herbs. He told me that I was going to perform a ritual that was going to change my life like forever. I was young and I was naive, and I was eager to please him, so I did not question a lot like what I used to do. He handed me a live rabbit. I don't know how and where he had gotten this rabbit. All of a sudden, he told me that he had caught a rabbit, and he instructed me to eat it right away. So I said, can you please give me some matches? And I wanted to cook that rabbit. This was what we used to do. When we would go into the bushes, we'll catch some birds and some small animals. Then we will eat them. So he said that he wanted me to eat it uncooked, raw, from head to tail, without cooking or killing it first. I was terrified, but my uncle was very persistent and he insisted that I was supposed to do this so that I can strengthen the spirit of my ancestor that had possessed my body. And after that, he told me what every man wants to hear. After I would have completed eating that rabbit, then I will be able to have power over women. No woman would ever be able to say no to me again. It is true, if you tell a man from Zim that this charm, even if it is poison, this charm can make any woman to say yes to him. I am telling you that within a day, every man in our country will die. Just try it. Advertise any charm and you say that this charm, if you drink it, all the women, they will say yes to you. You will see that it will be a country that will be left without men. So I took that rabbit with trembling hands. I did as I was told. I ate the rabbit, feeling its warm blood on my lips, its flesh tearing under my teeth. It was quite a horrifying experience, one that I will never forget. Afterwards, my uncle looked at me and I saw that he had pride, and he was looking at me with pride and told me that I was now a man. I had been blessed with a charm that would make me to be irresistible to women. From that day onwards, everything changed. As I grew older, that was when I started to notice that women, they seemed to be drawn to me in ways that I could not even explain. It did not matter where I was or who I was with, women would flock to me and they always wanted to sleep with me. I was not particularly good looking, but there is something about me that women can't even resist. I am someone who is not rich, but women, they cannot resist me. I have slept with women that are married to wealthy men. I have slept with women that are totally broke, but all of them, when I sleep with them, they will tell me that I have given them the best sex that they ever had in their life. There is something about me, and indeed, like my uncle told me, he said that you are going to become a magnet for women, my son, and no woman will ever be able to say no to you. By the time that I was in my 20s, I had already been with more women than I could ever count. My job as a truck driver only fueled my appetite for women. Since I was constantly on the road, I kept on meeting new women in each and every town and city that I would go and deliver. Zim first, South Africa, Botswana, no matter where I go, there are always women that are willing to sleep with me without even giving a woman anything. Some women, they can just hitchhike my truck, then we just talk, and the woman will say, I can't control myself. Please, can you just find a place where we can just go and do at least one time so that I can be okay? At first, I enjoyed it when I was still young, full of energy, and it was very addictive knowing that you can sleep with any woman that you lust against. I even slept with the pastor's wife. Women would always marvel at my manhood, because my uncle also made me to perform a ritual whereby you climb up what we call a sausage tree, then you pick any of the young fruits, then you keep on coming back until that sausage fruit is the size of the manhood that you want, then you cut it. So like I have a very big manhood, like the ones that you see in porn movies, and I have this ability to go for hours without ever tiring. I can be on top of a woman until she complains. Like I can easily go for 5 rounds in a night, leaving a woman exhausted, and after that she will be begging for more. I feel like a king sometimes. I feel like I am invincible. But now that I am getting older and older, like the excitement, it is no longer there. But the problem with these charms, they keep on bringing me more women. I now have 18 children. Believe you me, I have 18 kids. I have 9 kids with different South African women. I have 2 with women from Botswana, and I have 7 with women, different women from my own country. Each child born from a different woman. Most of them, I rarely even see them. I can't provide for them. Some of these women don't even want me in their lives. I can't blame them. Like I was never there for them. never a father to my children. Like, I am always too busy because these charms, they are now using me. And I keep on sleeping with different women. I feel really empty, Brother Nashi. As we are speaking right now, I have a couple of women that I am also sleeping with. To tell you the truth, if I were to count the number of women that I have slept with, they are more than 200 women that I have slept with. This is my own confession. Your dear listeners, right there was a message that was sent to me by one of our dear brother right there. Strange things indeed they do happen in this world. Just imagine 200 women. Yo.